This video contains spoilers regarding the Sith Warriors storyline. You have been warned.
Ah, you've arrived on Balmora. Excellent. Your contact there is Lieutenant Malivai Quinn. I trust you'll find him most helpful.
I have no doubt, Master.
This is an important mission, and I only entrust the finest. Quinn will meet you in his offices at Sobek headquarters. We will speak again as soon as he has briefed you.
Sir, I apologize, sir. It was the best I could do.
If that's your best, you're useless to me. I can shoot you dead with a clear conscience. Is that what you want?
No, sir.
Then focus, Jillins. Dismissed. I apologize for the delay, my lord. Lieutenant Malivai Quinn, I'm to be your liaison here on Balmora.
Darth Barriss says you're capable. I hope he's not mistaken.
I will earn that distinction, my lord. Lord Barriss will brief you personally, but I'm to acquaint you with the climate here on Balmora first.
By all means, go ahead.
Even though the Empire wrestled control of Balmora from the Republic during the war, we were never able to completely eradicate them. There is a rather sizable resistance movement. No one wants to admit it, but it's clear that the Republic is backing it.
The Republic cannot be tolerated.
I agree, my lord. It is my dream to see our enemy vanquished. I have a secure line to Lord Barriss. I'll patch him through immediately.
Ah, I see you've convened with my apprentice. Very good, Lieutenant. Leave us. Quinn owes his career to me, but we should keep the details of your mission between the two of us. We must act swiftly. Noman Kar's Padawan has directed the Jedi's suspicions to my undercover spy there on Balmora. Do you recall this?
Of course. I remember everything.
Good. I'll get to the point. My spy is Commander Rylan of the Republic Resistance. He is the central contact for all my operatives in this sector. Unfortunately, Quinn is tracking an investigator that the Jedi have sent. That means we have to cover our tracks before you kill Rylan. Your first mandate is to destroy evidence that links Rylan to the sabotaging of Balmora's defense systems during the war. To do so, you must break into the satellite control tower. Quinn reports that the tower is a death trap of mechanical security.
I'll handle anything that dares get in my way.
This task is priority one. The Jedi's investigator could be zeroing in on the evidence as we speak. Quinn has everything you'll need. I'll summon him back. Remember, he is not to know the reason for your mission. I'll be in touch.
My lord, I've prepared what you need for your assault on the satellite control tower. In order to destroy the mainframe, you'll mount this charge to the base and activate it. Then contact me, and I'll be able to detonate.
My lord, I mark your progress and see that the charge is armed. I will detonate once you are a safe distance. But first, I have Darth Barriss on Hollow for you. I will retreat and leave the line secure for the two of you.
Apprentice, we have one more potentially compromising thing to take care of before you can confront my spy, Commander Rylan. It involves invading a Republic keep to find a lowly ensign named Dermot. He is Rylan's son, and the commander confided his true identity to him. Ensign Dermot must be silenced permanently.
Rylan was foolish to tell his son.
The one chink in his otherwise flawless armor. I'll signal Quinn to give you the details. Be swift.
My lord, Ensign Dermot is being detained in the brig of the Republic Crater Outpost, awaiting questioning by the mysterious agent Barriss has me tracking. I will alert you if the investigator appears to be heading there. I assume you wish to get to Dermat before she does.
It's none of your business, Imperial.
I apologize, my lord. My inquiring mind often gets the best of me. I won't delay you any longer. Good luck on your mission, my lord. I'll be here if you need anything.
Down, Dermat. There's something going on outside. Trying to listen.
Oh, come on, Six. Throw me a bone. Who's this agent that's coming to interrogate me? At least answer me that, will ya? Fine, stay clamped. I don't care who it is, I ain't talking. Nobody's gonna get nothing out of me, nothing! All right, I ain't proud. I give. My dad's an Imperial agent.
What did you say? Your dad is a what?
Yes, please repeat that, Junior.
Oh no.
This is a restricted area. What are you doing here? Who are you?
It's not a who. It's a what? It's a Sith.
I am Death.
Like I couldn't tell you a bad news the moment I saw you. Take a look behind yourself, Sith. That's what two squads of the Republic's finest look like.
Finally, a fight worthy of me.
Come on, men. Let's send this Sith home in a body bag.
Zix! Come on, talk to me, Zix. Get up, man.
You are a pathetic waste of human space.
You're right. You're right. I'm worthless. Please, I know why you're here. The Republic. The Republic's investigating my dad, and an agent's coming to put the screws to me. But I won't break. I promise. Let me live. My dad's secret is safe with me. I'm a rock.
You must think I'm an idiot.
Fine. You're an idiot. If it'll save me, I'll think whatever you want me to. My father's done so much for the Empire. Look, maybe the apple fell off the tree. Kind of far from the tree, but it's still... Look, the apple's still... Look, I'm not exactly sure where I was going with that, but please don't kill me.
I'm putting you out of my misery.
But who will put me out of my misery?
Poor fool. Not sure we've ever come across anyone so useless.
If it wasn't for the entertainment value that collar provides, you'd be just as useless.
Ow! I'll try to do better.
Let's be honest. Your success at the Satellite Control Station and Republic Crater Outpost has surprised me, my lord. I computed the likelihood of success as nearly negligible. In my assessment, however, I only considered the capabilities of a typical Sith. Clearly, you are not a typical Sith. I will adjust future calibrations to account for your unprecedented abilities.
Don't let it happen again, Imperial.
You'll find my learning curve to be exceptionally responsive. Lord Barriss is pleased. He says it's time to zero in on your prime directive, and he awaits your contact. My barracks are yours. Activate the holocommunicator in the next room to speak with Lord Barriss. The line is secure.
You've been most helpful.
I'll be right here if needed, my lord.
Hope you can see the smile on my face, Apprentice. You are turning me into a true believer.
Wait a minute, let me pinch myself.
I'm sure you're impatient to complete your time on that little rock. With the satellite tower computer destroyed and Commander Rylon's son neutralized, my spy's tracks are covered. Now the only threat to Rylon ever being exposed is the man himself. It's time to end that threat. Permanently.
I'm going to wipe him off the face of this planet.
Ready and able. That's what makes you such a lethal and valuable asset. I've had him embedded within enemy ranks for decades. The extent of his contribution to the Empire's interests is unrivaled.
It's time to retire him. He served his purpose.
You took the words right out of my mouth, Apprentice. The Jedi Investigator must have no hard evidence that Rylon was killed to silence him. It must look like anything but a targeted execution. Annihilate everyone there.
There won't be a heart left beating.
See to that. I've summoned Lieutenant Quinn. He'll prepare you for your final task.
Your final target is the Balmoran Arms Factory. The Resistance forces recently captured it and made it their headquarters. An incursion into the Arms Factory will be a monumental feat. I'm excited by the prospect of you laying waste to that place.
Just spit out the details, Imperial. Try to contain yourself.
Yes, my lord. I will not stray from the facts again. All right. The Republic Command Center is deep inside the Arms Factory, the most heavily protected installation on the planet. In order to reach Commander Rylon, you will have to make your way past all of the factory's defenses, which are considerable.
The tougher, the better.
Stationed inside are an estimated 1,000 of the Republic's best trained soldiers. Specifically, Rylorn's elite squadron is responsible for some of the most precise, improbable resistance victories on Balmora. They're legendary.
I hate them already. I'll feed off that.
The Empire's cause here on Balmora will be greatly advanced once they're gone. One final thing. The investigator that the Jedi sent has been concentrating her activity around the arms factory. I have her under minute-by-minute surveillance. If she becomes a problem, I'll contact you on your comlink.
Sounds like a plan.
I'm on top of it. I will be here to salute you when the Balmoran arms factory is a smoking husk, my lord.
The factory is under attack. Headquarters has been breached and casualties are severe.
Keep your wits, Captain. What do we know of the enemy?
Target is carving a bloody path in this direction. Unconfirmed reports suggest it's Sith.
Consider them confirmed.
Commander, contact confirmed. The enemy is Sith. Repeat, the enemy is...
I can see that, Captain. Shut up.
Sith, I know why you're here. Be aware that these are the finest troops I've commanded in all my decades of duty.
Am I supposed to turn tail and run now?
My men and I would be disappointed if you did. Captain Elegen, engage at will and hold the line. I'm coming with reinforcements. Right on out.
You're about to find out what we're made of.
You're made of bones that break and blood that spills.
You don't intimidate us. We've killed your kind before.
You've never even seen my kind before.
You're about to find out otherwise.
Men, attack!
Commander, he should have been here by now.
Your commander is an Imperial spy.
You lie. Please, it can't be.
Must you rub it in, Sith?
Nice of you to join us, Commander.
No. Tell me what the Sith says isn't true.
I'm sorry, Captain Elegen. All these years, I've been a loyal soldier of the Empire.
No. I can't believe...
It's unfortunate they were on the wrong side. They were excellent soldiers and exceptional men.
Why didn't you convert them to our cause?
I follow Barriss's orders to the letter. Recruitment was never my purpose here. I serve for the glory of the Empire, but the life of a spy is a slippery one. In essence, I had to become a Republic soldier, and I've done things against the Empire that have sickened me.
At least your pain ends today.
Before I embrace my end, there is one thing I must know. My son, he was the only thing in the world that was truly mine, and in love or weakness, I told him my secrets. I know you had to cover my tracks, but please tell me, did he face his fate well?
He whimpered like a craven coward.
I see. You've crushed my spirit. Now the death of my body is a formality. When they find my corpse, there must be evidence of a valiant fight. We must make this look convincing, Sith. So I will not hold back. I will fight you as though you are my mortal enemy.
Maybe I'll break a sweat.
Then arm yourself. Tell Lord Barriss it has been my great honor to serve him.
My lord, I believe we've got trouble. I heard your entire conversation with Commander Rylorn.
What from my conversation makes you think we have trouble?
I told you that I've had the Jedi Investigator surveilled and that she's been snooping around the arms factory. Apparently she bugged Rylorn's quarters. And as she listened in on your conversation, I heard what she heard. The Investigator knows everything, my lord.
The same can be said of you now.
Yes, but I pose no risk to Lord Barriss. If this Investigator gets away, she'll expose everything. She was heading to her ship, but I had my men move in and cut her off from the Republic landing bay. I am systematically blocking her avenues of transmission and escape, herding that Republic scum to her only hope, the spaceport at Sobrik.
I will be there soon.
I'm afraid there's more, my lord. My men who engaged her report that she's wielding a lightsaber. It seems this investigator is a Jedi Knight. I advise caution when facing her.
Killing Jedi is old hat for me.
But my concern is unfounded. My apologies. I will gather my remaining men and meet you at the spaceport. We will crush this Jedi.
You're too late, Sith. I already transmitted the conversation between you and Commander Rylon to the Jedi Council. Noman Carr has his proof. Now Master Carr and his Padawan will track down and expose every Sith agent in the galaxy.
Mark my words, they will be hunted every step of the way.
You fight for a losing cause, Sith. I have purity of purpose. I seek neither thrills nor satisfaction. Unlike you, I am calm.
You know nothing about me.
I know that by the shortcuts you have taken, your strength is thin. The dark side shall fail you, Sith. Save yourself, surrender, and the Jedi Council will give you every opportunity to discover redemption.
I would rather be dead.
Attack me, and you will be. Your victory means nothing. The damage has been done. The proof has been transmitted. So deal the death blow, Sith. I am at peace. Knowing that the greater good has been served.
I hate to burst your bubble, Jedi. No, that's a lie. I'm reveling in it. I intercepted your transmission. The Jedi know nothing.
Your failure is complete. How do you feel now?
Gloat all you like. It means nothing. I remain at peace. And Noman Carr and his Padawan will still defeat you.
They will fall just as you have fallen.
I face my end, knowing what is true. I am resigned. Strike me down. I offer no further resistance.
I will savor your destruction.
There is no death. There is the Force.
How bizarre. She just closed her eyes and accepted death.
Sheer idiocy.
No matter. The threat is ended. Lord Barriss will be anxious to learn what became of this. When you're ready, I'll contact him from my office.
I will be there soon.
Excellent. I'll go prepare. I'll be waiting in my barracks. It's not my place, Lord Barriss. I leave that for your apprentice to convey.
Then step aside, Lieutenant. My apprentice has arrived. Nice of you to join us. Quinn refuses to update me, insisting the privilege be yours. I assume the Jedi investigator has been stopped.
She is dead, Master.
That is a relief. I had hoped to avoid confronting the Jedi, but our hand was forced. What matters most is that Rylon can no longer be exposed. And how would you assess Lieutenant Quinn's contribution?
He did his part.
Lieutenant, my apprentice's demeanor notwithstanding, I have been impressed with your efforts. You have more than made up what is owed to me. I'm putting you up for a captaincy and transmitting an executive order allowing you to station wherever you choose. You are dismissed.
Thank you, Lord Barriss. If my actions benefit the Empire, they benefit me. I would have done the same regardless of our past. My lord, before I depart, it's been my extreme honor to serve you. You are the epitome of everything the Empire stands for.
The honor has been mine, Captain.
Until we meet again, I salute you, my lord.
He will have his hands full. There are powerful Imperials dedicated to keeping him down. But if Quinn can overcome them and rise to the station he deserves, there is great hope for our Imperial allies.
If given the opportunity, he will excel.
By the way, it's not worth worrying about. Quinn's affairs are a speck compared to what we face. Your presence on Balmora is no longer needed. Return to your ship when you're ready to leave. I'll contact you there.
So, we're leaving, right? On to our next exercise in domination and destruction?
We don't have to leave to have an exercise in domination.
Okay. Point taken. Sure hope the next place we land on has a place to buy painkillers.
My lord, I hope you don't find my appearance here obtrusive. I beg an audience.
Begging does not become an officer.
Pardon my word choice, my lord. I will speak plainly. As you know, Lord Barriss enabled my reassignment anywhere I choose. It is an evolution I've longed for and assumed would never come. Aiding your mission on this planet has reawakened the ambition I began my career with, to make the most profound impact possible for the Empire.
Welcome back to life, Quinn.
That is how it feels, my lord. I cannot think of a more glorious and honorable way to make a difference in the galaxy than to serve you. I'm here to pledge myself to you. I'm ready and willing to serve in whatever capacity you see fit.
What exactly can you do, Captain?
Who cares what he can do? I could use some help around here.
There are some things only you can do for me, Vet.
My lord, if given the chance, I know I will prove myself to you. I'm a top-notch pilot, military strategist, and a deadly shot. I can fly this ship, plan your battles, assess your enemies, and kill them. You won't find a more tireless and loyal subject. I offer my military prowess and dedicate every ounce of my strength to your cause.
All right. I'll find something for you to do.
An opportunity is all I ask. Thank you, my lord. I will submit my reassignment papers as we depart.
So I see you are ready to put Balmora behind you. Good. The elimination of Commander Rylon grants security to my spy network, but there is still more to be done.
I'm primed for the next bloodbath.
I weep for anyone who gets in your way. Now, before I unleash you on Noman Carr and his Padawan, you must eliminate my spy on Nar Shaddaa. Head there immediately.
My lord, I have settled into my quarters and fully acquainted myself with the ship. I am at your disposal.
I want you on a persistent state of alert, Captain.
I won't disappoint, my lord. I am fully trained in all aspects of operating this vessel. I can navigate and pilot it to perfection.
You'll have to prove yourself, Captain.
I'm ready, my lord.
You wish to speak?
Yes, my lord. I wanted to update you on the condition of your ship. It has responded extremely well to my optimizations. I'm pleased to report that we are operating at peak efficiency.
I will accept no less, Captain.
Of course, my lord. There will be no slippage.
If there are deficiencies you see, or suggestions you have about my operations and missions, I want you to speak up.
I will make such things clearly known. You can count on me. Permission to speak freely, my lord?
Go ahead, Captain.
There's a reason I was languishing on Balmora before you arrived. A decade ago, I served under Moff Broisk at the Battle of Druckenwell. Moff Broisk made a critical oversight that brought the fleet to the brink of complete defeat. I ignored his order and turned the tide to victory.
I take it the Moff took exception to that.
Your intuition is flawless, my lord. Broisk took credit for the reversal, which is fine. But then he court-martialed me. Darth Barriss assigned me to Balmora, or my career would have been over. Moff Broisk has blocked every transfer and promotion I've been up for since.
I have no tolerance for fools like this Moff.
I could say more about him, my lord, but my point is made. I serve you now, I have no regrets. I'll return to my duties. My lord, I have been working on something in my spare time. You may be interested.
Let me be the judge of that.
Right away. Years ago, I was zeroing in on a notorious SIS agent called Volorin, when Moff Broisk recalled me to the Battle of Druckenwell. I had the spy cornered. I briefed Broisk so that he could send someone else to take Volorin out. He ignored the opportunity.
This sounds like a personal vendetta.
I'll admit, knowing how close I was to ending his career made languishing on Balmora all the more frustrating. But I take this on only for the good of the Empire. This spy has caused immeasurable losses. I know Volorin's signature. and by tracking his accomplishments, I've picked up his scent.
Follow your little imperial pursuits as you see fit.
I'll keep you abreast of my progress.
Okay. I can't take this anymore. Look, I throw myself on your mercy or whatever. Please. Just please remove this collar.
Let me see if I can find the right button.
Real nice. Jerk. You think that's gonna break me?